signs and secrets all around us, in symbolism. Well, today we're going to take a look at Afghanistan, Kazakhstan. Jamaat people have said the whole city is in the shape of the New World Order and actually mapped out their plans. There's a lot of grid work, or like a circuit board work, right?
Także bardzo długi był ten program About City. No.
Był konkurent Astany. To jest zaproponizm amerykańskiego, czyli Denver.
Denver. Także może oni nam dostarczą w Jaśku jakieś jeszcze nowe informacje w internecie.
Mm-hmm.
And we will be free because of the information. Uh-huh. I can hear. Oui, oui. C'est ça. Zawsze to jest ciekawe, wiesz? No każde informacje są ciekawe i trzeba je na to brać poprawki też, bo w końcu jesteśmy ludźmi myślącymi, a człowiek błąka się po bezdrożach plotek z całego świata. Tak. Także to jest muzyka Denver. To oni przejmują sedę chyba po tym Watykanie. Ten Denver. Po tym Watykanie przejmują sedę. Ojejko, proszę Państwa, żeście się uśmiały, śmieszne. No. Mhm.
By
Our special guest tonight is Alex Christopher, author of Pandora's Box, an expose of the British instigation through Washington, D.C. over the last 200 years. You thought you were free. This stuff has been going on forever. The idea was to make us perceive we were free and independent, but actually we are still subject to the British Commonwealth. She has a lot of information here, and we are going to have her back again for more, according to her last night. Just a fascinating individual. She is going to talk about the Montauk Project and extraterrestrial abilities and more. Last night, we talked about a few things. We talked about the Denver Airport and what is really going on there, and we talked a bit about the Montauk Project and our failing. And then we skipped around a bit about some of the things in Pandora's box. You mentioned that the Queen of England has been buying up a lot of property in Colorado under an alias. Why don't we start on the subject of the British?
All right. The information, primary, that is in Pandora's box, comes from a major corporation, railroads and banking systems, which contributes to a job. Virginia Company, and there was a survivor to the massacre of the royalty in France during the French Revolution, Marie Antoinette, and Kenny was found, the Dauphin, who survived and was smuggled out of France. The Dauphin went to the United States, there, England, where he signed a contract with the Virginia Company. He came here to help the businesses, especially banking, in the United States. But he won that. Everything would remain under English control, or the Soviet too. And that brings us not out of there, because we are still looking at everything falling under the justice and going back to the crown system. It is my folly to think that everyone in this country is led to believe that people in the United States that won independence from England when in fact they're negative.
Well, the good President Bush, well, in 2 years ago, he went to England to unite his balance. Where is that coming from? Is it that he was a faithful servant?
You bet. All of them are doing the bidding, and it goes back to their secret society and the establishment of the New World Order, which all leads back to the House of Windsor. There has been a dysfunction for a long time of the Windsor process, whereby people carry on the business of the Crown of England. That was one of the things that this absorbing the most followers was set up to achieve. Cecil Rhodes set it up to groom people for this task, to carry the United States into the New World Order. It appears, from what I have been able to find out, that the Crown of England has had this very supportive plan for hundreds of years, and it would be possible that they have been physical information that not many of us have about the chaos involving earth changes that is coming. It is my understanding that England is not going to make it through the changes, so they set up the whole new empire over here. That goes back to some of the things we discussed before about land being bought up in Colorado.
Yes, yeah, that is a pretty high altitude where it will be safe.
Yes. But all the symbolism that is apparent in the layout of a new Denver airport. That it is the control center, the world control. There is a lot of secret society symbology at the airport. We started researching all of this to find out what it all means. It's all very scary. A gentleman by the name Val Bailey, who has been involved in some very unusual government projects in the past, told me that the Denver area is where the establishment of the Western sector of the New World Order will be in the United States. Little bits and pieces keep coming to me, confirming things I have not yet confirmed.
Do you know of John Coleman?
The Committee of 300?
Yes. What's your take on that?
I think his information is fantastic. If he had the information that I put in Pandora's box when I put them together, it would have blown his mind. But as far as I know from my standpoint, both sets of material go hand in hand, right down the line.
Some of these things about the background of the British invasion, taking over the land of Lakia, while they let us think that we are running this country.
how they have those people in power in Russia years ago, how they have pushed the socialist revolution, like they say, the sun never sets on British soil, about some of these things, on the airport in Denver, would you mind discussing some of those things again?
Well, the first thing that got my attention at the airport was the capstone that I saw in the photograph that had a Masonic symbol on it. So, I really wanted to go to the airport and see that, because I thought it would be very unusual. The capstone was a dedication stone for the Denver airport, and the Masonic symbol on it. The whole group of us went out to the airport to see some friends of and see this capstone, which also had a time capsule embedded inside it. It was the last piece inside of the temple, which, by the way, is called the Great Hall, which is what Masons refer to as their meeting hall. And on this thing it mentioned the New World Airport Commission. I have never heard of that. Have you?
Never.
It has a Masonic symbol on it, and it also has very unusual geometric designs. It depicts an arm rising up out of it. That curves at a 45-degree angle. It also has a thing that looks like a keypad on it. This capstone structure is made of carved granite and stainless steel, and it is very fancy. Over the keypad area at the end of the arm has an outer plate and finished wooden block sitting on it. But gentlemen, that little bee, on the first trip out of the airport, has since died. They say he committed suicide, but everything else tells me that this is not possible. No one can double-tie a castle behind his own neck and strangle himself. I just don't think that it is possible. But his name was Phil Schneider, and he started blowing the whistle on all this stuff going on in the underground bases that he had helped build for years and years. He worked on the underground bases at Area 51 and gone to New Mexico, as well as several other cases. Schneider told me that this keypad-looking area looks like a form of techno geometry, that's a radium or engine, and that it had something to do with a directional system, whatever that meant, that functioned as a homing beacon to bring ships right into the Great Hall. In the same general area, where this capsule goes from most unusual designs on the floor to all the sun in the nature, which reflects back to the black sun, which goes back to Marx's symbology. See, the secret society was supposedly into sun worship. The Nazis were into black sun worship, which connects with the idea of Saturn. Saturn and Satanism kind of go hand in hand. Then, we have this system of new rules at the airport that are the most grotesque thing you've ever seen.
What's on the murals?
I'm afraid that the base towers are what the ground is used and the world as a whole. Not what has happened or some fantasy. One of them, that is very unusual, has three castles of dead people in them.
That's part of the ritual connected with the stolen boat map.
Yes. And there are, I didn't see, TVs of people if they would like to see dead. The first casket, that's what the artist told me, was a Jewish American child, a little girl, and she has this star on her clothes, and a little luggage, and a locket.
Jewish lineage was passed through the people.
Yes. Well, all these caskets depict women who are dead. Then, in the center casket, Hell depicted a Native American woman, and the last casket has a black woman in it. Now, normally I would not have thought too much about these new rules if I had not done a lot of research. Even in the government documents, I have run across gene splicing discussions on how they would like to splice out specific races, and also whoever these people are, do not like the Jewish people. This is just one of the huge murals. This same mural depicts the destruction of the city and the forest, and there is a little girl holding a Mayan serpent that speaks of the destruction of civilization. There is a mural that depicts this thing standing over a city that looks like a green Darth Vader with a sword that has destroyed the city. This character is huge, and there is a road depicted with women walking, holding dead babies. This same model extends over to another one, which depicts all of the children of the world taking the weapons from each country on earth and giving them to a central figure, which is a German boy who has his iron soaked and dangled in his hand. That is broken out of proportion for the child's body to see the whole thing to the bar chair. I thought, well, no, no, I'm a German child that not only do we have a secret society behind this, but that it is a German secret society working in the vicinity of the New World Control Center.
It is interesting when you consider Operation Paperclip, wherein all these Nazis were brought to the United States to be groomed, financed, and basically brought back into power.
Well, I know they are here because I have seen them, alongside the Americans, in the more sensitive areas of the airport. But these things are the most disturbing and very unusual. When I first tried to contact the artist, I talked to him about the continuous disturbance that he was given guidelines and putting them. When I showed up in his studio, I asked to see the guidelines for the last two he was working on. He suddenly went brain dead and said, of course, there are no guidelines. It took myself and two other people over 8 months to figure out all the symbology that is embodied in these murals. It turned out that some of these are trigger pictures containing symbology designed to trigger all the personalities of people that have been groomed in MK-Ultra type programs for specific tasks, but they have been trained to do into something connected with the organic rituals and mind control. I had one woman that called me out of the blue one night, and she was really disturbed about some information. She told me many different things, but later turned out to be known as MK-Ultra triggers. Also, almost every aspect of these neurons contains symbols relating back to secret societies. When you get the overall view of what they are talking about in these things, it is very, very scary. It goes
very sadly.
Diversity It took a very long time to travel this stuff down and figure out what they are trying to say. The one way to tell stories is in fiction. It's right there in our face when you go into the airport. Most people look at them and say, boy, those are crazy looking pictures. What are they doing at this airport?
Ta lotniska. No spara tam.
Some interesting facts about the international airport. The airport is built in 1995.
Także proszę Państwa, będziemy z Polski lecieć, to następnym razem pojedziemy, polecimy właściwie do Denver. Chciałabym swoją kuzynkę, szatanicę, odwiedzić, proszę Państwa.
The initial cost of this feat was to be $1.7 billion, and by the time they were done playing games, having problems, getting bailed out and got extra government money and money from private corporations on top of that, it cost about $4.8 billion, exceeding the total budget. words used to describe the airport were there even technical problems, poor project management, overwhelmed complexity, and America's most inconvenient airport. It was built in a high wind area. Stapleton had not recorded it to be shut down or flights delayed off. The extensive automated baggage system was so messed up, such a circus of errors, that it was worse than unusable. It was an industry joke, but it had to be built and filled there. Some say the reason that the airport was built and there was no stopping it, no cost spared to do so, and why it was so over budget and it took so many years to build, is because it's really an underground military base combined with a civilian detainment camp. And new information has surfaced that it could be a safe haven for the world's elite after the economic breakdown in America, even though the area is basically flat at the expense of time that has taken extensively lower some areas and raise others. They move 110 million cubic yards of earth around. This is about one third of the amount of earth they move, and they dug out the Panama Canal. The airport is at the Galactic Communications Core, made of 5,300 miles of cable. That's longer than the Miami. That's in New York City, Buenos Aires, Argentina. The airport also has 11,365 miles of continental communications network. The fueling system has become 1,000 gallons of jet fuel per minute through the 28-mile network of pumps. There are 6 cubical tanks which hold 2.73 million gallons of jet fuel. This is somewhere in Earth. No one will ever need this much, really. Granite was imported from all over the world, Asia, Africa, Europe, North and South America, and used in making the main terminal floor. This is a ridiculous expense, especially when you're already over budget. They say the floor pattern echoes the roof design and subtly reinforces passenger flows. A huge maze that was in Jefferson Terminal, named after Henry Jefferson, who was the first person to create that specifically for aviation. The company is still in business today. This area is known as the Great Hall. It's said this is what the Masons named their meeting place. It is 900 feet by 210 feet. This is for the 1.5 million square feet. Also, there is 46 million square feet of public space at the airport. The airport grants that they have room to build another terminal and two more concourses and could serve 100 million passengers a year. The airport flew 36 million in 2001. The entire roof of the airport is made of 50 acres of Teflon cookie close to fiber glass. The same material is on the inside as a layer also. The place looks like a bizarre scene out of the movie View, comprised of huge spiked fence-like structures. The material reflects 90% of the sunlight and doesn't conduct heat, so you can't see into the place with radar or see heat signatures. The only way to get to the other two concourses or terminals from the Great Hall, or vice versa, is by the airport train system. There are more than 19 miles of conveyor belt track, luggage transport cars, and roads, and their own underground tunnels that move baggage and goods. They're so huge you can drive trucks through them, and some remain unused. You mentioned that this airport goes down many levels. Does the fact that all these underground levels of air have something to do with why it took so long for this airport to open?
Well, the gentleman that I was dealing with, Phil Schneider, said that during the last year of construction, they were connecting the underground airport system with the deep underground base. The company will have at least an 8-level deep underground base there and at the other end, or 0.5 square miles underground city, and an 8.5 square mile base underneath the airport. It is very unusual that they would have lost the 50 square mile area on the surface, which can locate an airport in the middle of New York. They really can use it for something very unusual. There will be many miles following highway up to this airport, and there is nothing else there between the airport and Denver. Not even a service station, at least in September 1995. The people of Denver are really upset with the fact that this airport went in the way it did. There was this fellow who wrote a book in which he made the statement that they were talking in a real state, which Denver city official was talking to the people of the civil intelligence agency, and that he would pay $1.5 million to allow the airport to be built, no matter what it took. It appears that there was a lot more interest in getting the airport built from just officials in the Denver area. They plan on using this facility for something else other than just landing planes.
So, this guy got you down there to take a look at the underground?
Well, he was invited to go along on the trip. I had a friend that actually got us down into the active area in the underground. It's very interesting down there. The baggage equipment area is very unusual. All the old luggage equipment that wouldn't work right doesn't look much different than the stuff that is working today.
You were telling me that there are huge concrete corridors with sprinklers all along the ceiling. What are these sprinkler heads doing in a concrete bunker, pray tell?
Well, this is the same question we asked. These shops are huge and run along adjacent to the tram line on both sides. So, there are two of these huge shops, large enough to fit up two lanes. Highway in there. There are very few openings into and out of the tram shaft is at the end of them, going out into this 50 square mile bay bridge with a huge steel door that would facilitate the entrance of a great big truck. It could be used for almost anything, but what is so unusual about it is that about every 5 or 6 feet on the ceiling, across almost the whole width of the area, there is a pipe with 3 or 4 sprinkler heads. This goes on to the full length of the thing, which must be close to the mine. There are two of these shops, and I got a picture in the mail the other day, which was very unusual. It was taken by someone on board the tram of the shaft. The picture appeared to actually show goat-like figures on it. It was a mother and a baby wrapped in a blanket. When you were down in that concrete shaft, both times I got nauseated. Now, the tram shaft. When the tram comes in on, it's connected up with an underground tunnel coming in from 5 buildings that were built and buried. There was already a 40-foot diameter tunnel there when construction started. Those 5 buildings were built 3.5 years ago, and suddenly they said, oops, we're in the wrong place, and buried them, along with a very high-tech runway that was very underground storage in the dirt. It's always in place. But they would build a very technical building complex with interlocking systems, and the tunnel going up to the tram tunnel at the concourse, and then state that they built it in the wrong place and covered up the dirt. I don't believe that people are that stupid.
No, projects like that are strategically planned, and they just don't go and do that.
Some of these 5 buildings are 150 feet tall. There is one 78 feet tall, and one that is 126 feet tall. We are all at that range. From this complex, there is a shaft that runs to Concourse C. When they started this project, as I said, there was also a huge 40-foot diameter shaft brought in there from somewhere that was not in this roadway crew. It was there when the project was started. And everybody had worked on the project. There were 5 different contractors, and the people on each contracted crew did not interact with the other ones. When the project was done, everyone was fired and sent away.
you to think that during this massive construction, they would not be able to keep this stuff secret?
I think lots of the people call things and disturb them so much that they would not talk about it. I know several people who worked on the project who managed to find their way down into the depths, probably close to the deep underground base, and saw things that scared them so badly they won't talk about it. I interviewed a few of the former employees on the construction crew that worked out along these buildings that ended up buried, and they are afraid to talk. They say that everybody is real nervous about it, and they decided to tell some of the secrets that they knew, but they don't want anybody to know who they are. So, I can tell you that it is a very unusual and spooky time to play, and if you are a sensitive person, you get nauseated as soon as you enter the perimeter of the airport, especially when you go down underground. You become very nauseated and nervous. There is also so much electromagnetic flux in the area that if you get out on the open ground around the airport, you will buzz.
Where is this flux field coming from? What do you think the purpose of this
is? I think that it's coming from some kind of underground electrical system, because where we work, there were no power lines, and the whole place was just buzzing with the energy floating around. Very unusual. In addition, there are areas in the underground that have chain link fences with the barbed wire tops pointed in them, like they were there to keep people in, not to keep people out. All these areas are there to take care of it, and none of it is a magic thing. The main process goes on. One area in particular is forbidden to go into unless you are wearing a biological protective suit. They say there is some kind of unidentified biological fungus in that area that attacks people's lungs.
Come. Some kind of way to hide something that lives in this area.
Well, we think the area is one that goes to people levels underground at the airport, but it is surrounded by a chain link fence, and we can't get in there. We think this is the area that one of the electricians kind of stumbled into that went down about 6 levels below the 4th level and ran into some really weird stuff. We won't talk about any of it now.
Really weird stuff?
Also, at the airport, there are a lot of miniature nuclear reactor cooling towers, and I don't understand why they are there. When people ask, the reply is that they are part of the ventilation and the course system.
What do you think it's for?
I think it is all hooked up to the deep underground.
A satellite view of these ventilation systems measure over 50 feet tall, 249 feet across, and 363 feet in diameter. And this is only what is visible on the surface. Notice the jet sitting on the top left-hand corner. It could actually be one of those shafts. Just when I thought the murals and the gargoyle statue made the airport bizarre enough, on Monday, February 11, 2008, this 6-ton, 32-foot-tall, that the glass sculpture was erected at the airport in 1992. It was commissioned at the cost of $300,000. This is the largest statue ever created by 66-year-old Louis Timonek, who in June 13, 2006, was standing on a ladder in the studio in Congo, New Mexico, when a cable broke and a piece of the sculpture came crashing down, hitting him against a steel beam and slicing through an artery of his head. He died on his studio floor, leaving his family to the nation's sculpture. The airport originally wanted to have laser beams beaming from its sides, but they were replaced with red lights instead, so they would continue to glow. And the reason for these glowing eyes is quoted by the airport so they would ward off evil spirits. A good thing to have at an airport. Unquote.
Jest powiązane i z Bohemia, i Masoneria, i Kosmos, wszystko jedno zdało się, i zmiana tak zwana przez czasoprzestrzeni, wszystko jest powiązane. Ale to jest dla wtajemniczonych, a te szalecki nie wiedzą nic. To jest bardzo skomplikowane. To wszystko się nie składa w jedną całość, w tym szalecki.
Tak.
Natomiast tej elicie się składa się? Także oni tak, najpierw Żydów wykorzystają, żeby rozwalić Słowian, a potem tych Żydów jako naziści, zagazując Denver, tych, widziałeś tam takie były dospytkiwania, tak jak u wiklerowców, takie komory gazowe.
Tak, on widział, no i co?
No i tam Żydów ściągnął do tego roku, zagazują.
Ściągnął?
No ja, co to myślisz, że biali by tolerowali, żeby tak swoje tereny? Po co komory gazowe, podziemia piotryska, dla niego?
A może wiesz, może mniej zachodu, żeby mieli? Po prostu.
Ale pod ziemią są komory gazowe, no. I tysiące klatek na ludzi do przechowywania tych dogazowania, pod tym lotniskiem, Znaczy, że będą ewakuacje Nowego Jorku do zgazowania, a potem jeszcze spopielenia tych zbogów.
A potem jeszcze spopielenia. To jest obowiązek, proszę Ciebie, to nie takie łatwe jest kogoś zamordować. No. Salon uszatana.
Gdzie masz pod jego powierzchnią?
Tak. Salon uszatana.
No nie, salon uszatana. Ale takie tam tłumy będą gazowane. Zobacz, tam są kilkaset metrów takich korytarzy tam. I te właśnie, te rurki do gazu są na górze.
Tak.
Tak jak u nas, proszę powtarzać, że to sytuacja z Warszawy, z tym gazowaniem w tym tunelu koło lotu zachodniego.
Tak.
Symbolika jest powtarzana.
Tak. Sharon Stone uszatana. Ja tak już jestem!
Pamiętasz, jak oni szukali ci polscy inżynierowie bań gazowych?
No.
Tam były takie banie gazowe.
Banie, ale tam wypustki są, no. Banie jak banie, wiesz, co mogło zostać? To chyba raczej te wypustki.
I pewnie na podstawie tych doświadczeń dworca zachodniego zbudowali ten Denver.
Tak. Tak, tak.
Tu gazowali, tam będą gazowali jeszcze swoich.
Tak, bo...
Zagazowali Żydów, a tam jeszcze...
Mało cudzych, mało obcych, to jeszcze i swoich, właśnie.
Dlatego w Kazachstanie jest napisane, że tam jest godzina 00 w Astanie, w Astanie, a chodzi o atak atomowy, żeby zniszczyć to
miasto
i spopielić całą USA jeszcze, co zgadowane. Bo Rosjanie chcą zniszczyć.
Tak, tak. Kupę prochu. Kupę prochu. Tak to było. Żebyś wiedział, że tak to jest. Tak to
jest. A czy nasi ludzie to jest nierozpoznali? Tym, że oni właściwie chcą ich zlądować na swoim terytorium.
To jeszcze i tak są święci, skoro chcą zgazować. To ile roboty?
Ale to krematoria trzeba
wykonać. Tak, to trzeba wykonać, wybudować, to nie takie proste.
Pojemność jest na zgazowanie kilku milionów.
Tak, to wszystko nie jest takie proste. Wymaga opieki, wymaga uwagi. Oj, Denver. Będzie Denver. Się poprawiłem. I się pocałuję. Tak. Tak, tak. Szatana znak. Thank you.